to my class. And here we are again in the spring season, the season of the flowers, blooming beautiful flowers. Can you have a look to these roses or to the white bunches of jasmine, to the red flowers of gulmohar? Let me show you the bunch of the flower of champa here. Flowers, let it be small, big, or any color, they are so beautiful. These small white flowers have their own beauty. The flowers like cathranthus, pink and white color. And the fruit, pomegranate. The flowers of the pomegranate are also so beautiful. Can you have a look to these flowers with small little buds? Last but not the least, this bunch. Actually, this bunch is not the bunch of the flower. Most of them considered it as flower, but we will search flower in it in our lesson. Okay, so let's study the basic structure and function of the parts of the flower. Let me collect and I'll show you all the parts of the flower. So my dear students, I have collected few flowers for you to explain the structure of the typical flower. If I talk about the typical flower, it has four important parts, or in the scientific form we can say it has four valves. If all these four valves or all these four parts are present in a flower, then it is considered to be a complete flower. To explain the structure of a typical flower, I have taken the example of hibiscus and gulmohar. The first part, which is quite visible, is this green leaf-like structure, which is called as sepals. Here you can see it, while it is quite visible in this flower also. The function of this sepal is very clear when the flower is in bud condition. As you can see here, it is protecting the bud. It is also quite visible here in this part where the gulmohar bud is being protected by the sepals. The second most important part, which is quite visible in the flower, are the colorful petals. Have a look on these colorful petals. The number, the structure, the size of the petals can vary flower to flower, but the function of the petal is same. The function of the petal is to attract the insects for pollination. Now let us talk about the third important valve of the flower. For this we have to remove the sepals. So let me first remove the sepals, which is green in color and involving the process of photosynthesis. Then petals, one by one we will remove the petals to see the third most important part. And here we go. This part is the female reproductive part, which is called as gynoecium. Gynoecium is also called as carpel or pistil in the lower classes. This gynoecium is being made up of three important parts. These are, first, ovary, in which female gametes are present. Let me just cut and show you the female gametes, that is the ovules here, which can be easily seen under a simple microscope. The second part of the gynoecium is the long style. This is the style. And the third part is the sticky stigma. This is the same part where the pollens come and stick and form the pollen tube through the long style to get ovule fertilized. Here, ovule, which is a female gamete fuses with male gamete, that is pollen. Then the fourth valve of the flower, or the fourth important part of the flower, is male reproductive part, which is called as androecium. Androecium is also called as stamen in the lower classes. If we just touch the androecium, the yellow color powder which comes in my hand are actually the male gametes, called as pollen. These pollen can also be very easily seen under a simple microscope. The anther on which the pollen are been stuck is attached through the filaments. Here we can see many filaments and many anthers attached here. The structure of androecium, gynoecium is different in different flowers. Let us now take the example of another flower where we will see these structure. I'll pick up my gulmohar flower here, and as we have dissected the hibiscus, in the same manner we will dissect the gulmohar, removing first sepals, then petals, the second bulb. And when we remove the petals, here we can see the bulging ovary, which is very prominent here. The base of the flower is also been visible here, which is called as thalamus part. This is the part where we get nectar, and to suck this nectar, the insect sits on the flower and the pollination process happens. Now let me just show you the structure, the third and fourth valve of the flower. Let me first remove this, which is the male reproductive part, and inside this we will get the female reproductive part, which was being said to be the gynoecium, if you remember. See here, the structure of the gynoecium is different what we have seen in the hibiscus. Similarly, the structure of androecium is also quite different and interesting here. Here this is anther, and the anther is attached with the flower through the long filament. So we can see here the structure, the number, the pattern is very different in every flower. In this flower of champa, there are no sepals, so I will not consider this flower to be a complete flower. So I hope now the structure of flower is clear. But let me just remind you what I promised. I promised you to show and search the flower in this bougainvillea, which was being considered as the bunch of flowers. But let me show this small white color structure here, which are actually small flowers. These flowers have very small petals, and these petals are then unable to attract any insects. So here this plant have adapted itself by coloring the leaves which surrounds this flower. Is it not interesting? So this was all about the world of flowers and the structure of the typical flower. I hope you understood this very nicely. And it's time to recap. You can just pause the video and draw the diagram which we are going to discuss right now. If we just talk about the flower, the typical flower, the green part of the flower which was protecting the bud was sepals. Then second bulb of the flower, the colorful petals. The third part of the flower was female reproductive part, which is called as gynoecium. Gynoecium contains three main parts, that is ovary, style and stigma. The ovary contains the female gametes, which is called as ovule. The next most important part of the flower is male reproductive part, which is called as androecium. Now, if I just talk about androecium, androecium contains two main parts. One, the filament, which attach the anther to the flower. Anther contains male reproductive gametes, which is called as pollen. Now, I hope the structure of the flower is very clear to you all. Thank you for watching this video and happy learning.